वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। अकॉर्डिंग टू जनरल थ्योरी ऑफ रिलेटिविटी, ग्रेविटी इज ज्योमेट्री। वी कैन एक्सप्रेस ग्रेविटी इन टर्म्स ऑफ ज्योमेट्री एंड वी ऑल्सो नो दैट ऑल दी लॉज ऑफ फिजिक्स आर इनवेरियंट अंडर कोऑर्डिनेट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। सो हाउ कैन यू यूज ज्योमेट्री टू एक्सप्लेन ग्रेविटी? इन ज्योमेट्री वी नो दैट द कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ टू पॉइंट्स आर नॉट सेम। If this is the coordinate system and these are two points, their coordinates are different. This one can be x1, y1, then this can be other than x1, y1. It means x2, y2. And we know that we can only use invariant quantity. So what are those invariant quantity? Invariant quantity are distance between any two points. ds is invariant quantity which doesn't change under coordinate transformation. So we can use, and this ds, distance between two points, is called line element. So in the Cartesian coordinate system, this is the Cartesian coordinate system. X, Y, and this one is X plus DX, Y plus DY. And distance between these two point AB is, AB is called DS. And DS is line element. Again, if we use polar coordinate, this is angle phi and this one is r and this is r phi. Coordinate of point A is R phi and this is another point B, and the coordinate of B is R plus DR phi plus D phi, and this value of this one is R D phi. So the distance between A and B is again ds. So the value of ds is same in polar coordinates as well as in Cartesian coordinates. So we can use line element to express gravity. First of all, we have to understand this concept called line element. How can we find the line element? ds square is simply dx square plus dy square. Again, in terms of polar coordinate, ds square is dr square plus r square d phi square. These are the value of line element. This one is in Cartesian coordinate, this one is in polar coordinate. And x is equal to r cos phi, y is equal to r sin phi. The connection between Cartesian coordinate and polar coordinate. And dx is equal to dr cos phi minus r sin phi d phi, and again dy is equal to r cos phi dr sin phi plus r cos phi d phi. And we know that ds square is equal to
dx square plus dy square. So we can find the line element. Line element is important in general theory of relativity because line element is invariant quantity. So we can, and also in GTR we have to find the curvature of space and time. We cannot use coordinates of point because coordinates of two point is not invariant, but the distance between two nearby point is invariant quantity. So we can use line element. So line element is important in general theory of relativity. Again, if we use another coordinate system, first of all we have to find the coordinate of two point and then we can calculate line element ds using the coordinates of two point.